Hi, everybody. Today we're going to talk a little bit about the history of our foam technology and how it was developed. It was a long process. It took about 8 years, but if you remember from our story, we started out working for a development company and designing buildings and offices that were really quiet and had really good sounding rooms. The development company wanted that as a feature of their campaign, and of course their rates reflected the extra costs involved. So I was given some guys and some research, and we came up with our own foam. We weren't happy with what was out there. I sat in a lot of rooms that had the traditional foams that were in the marketplace at the time, and they all treated voice in the same way. It was a little bit too much on the high end and not enough on the low end, and there was always this imbalance. I thought there wasn't a naturalness, an absorption rate that really let the timbre of each voice come through. Men and women's voices kind of sounded the same all the time. So we set out to create something. We knew that we had to stay a little bit more absorption in the lower frequencies, and that was our design objective. So basically, that's what we did. Let's look at what was similar in the marketplace at the time. There was a lot of foams that anything over 500 cycles, you know, was 100% absorption. So that wasn't the difficult part. It's after the 500 cycles that performance start to fall off, especially down into the 125 cycle range. So it was this area here between 500 and 125 that really needed the work. Now, why foam? It's convenient, it's lightweight, it's relatively easy to manufacture. It doesn't itch and scratch like insulation does, and you don't have to wear protective hazmat gear to work with the stuff. So foam is a good way to go. It's lightweight, which really helps for handling and building purposes. So our design goals were get something below 500 cycles and get it so it was good. Well, a lot of things on the marketplace had a low start, and then when they got to 500, they'd zoom right up. Well, I wanted something that was a little bit smoother. It didn't have that big dip in it from 125 to 500. And if you'll study our absorption curves, I'm sure they'll put the graphic up for you. And you can see the difference. You can also go to our website and look at the difference. And it's this area right here. It's the area on the graph from 125 to 250 and then to 500. That makes all the difference, and that's why our foam is so different sounding, wonderful for vocals and music, and it just brings out the timbre qualities, the tonal qualities, and actually moves the singers a little bit forward for you on the sound stage and even in the mix a little bit.